Hello students, I am Shikha Parikh from Sri Vasishth Vidyalaya. Today in this video, again we are going to continue with the same chapter of class 4 of social studies, that is human resources part 2. So in this video we are going to discuss some of the problems faced by people due to increasing population. Which are the problems? So the first one is shortage of food and water. If the population is high, then they have to face the shortage of food and water. Means they do not get enough quantity of food and water to fulfill their daily requirements. See here, due to the shortage of food, how these children are so much thin. The scarcity of food is easily seen in their body. Okay, and shortage of water. If we have many people to have the water, to use this water as a drinking for fulfill their daily needs. So, but obviously we are facing the water scarcity. So this is the first problem of people faced due to the increasing population. If I can tell you one simple example, let's say an apple. Okay, if you are the only one in the family who are going to eat this apple, then how much amount of apple you will get the full amount, full apple 100%. But suppose if you have one brother or sister also in your family, then you have to divide this apple into two halves. Then now how much quantity will you get? You will get only half quantity, 50% only, and 50% you have to share with your brother or sister. Suppose you have another one more member to share, then again you have to divide this apple into three parts, then again you have to share. Yes, so like the same way, whenever we are increasing in number, then we have to divide the resources, and due to this particular problem we have to face the shortage of food and water. Clear? Next problem is shortage of schools and colleges. Schools and colleges are very much important. Without schools and colleges, how will you learn? Okay, so schools and colleges is also not available due to the increasing amount of population. How? So we know that if we have a number of people, okay, number of children in our country, but we have the limited amount of schools in our country, then how can we adjust all the children into the schools? Okay, so maybe it may possible that some of the children can be facing this particular problem, shortage of schools and colleges due to the number of seats available in the schools and colleges. Clear? Next, we have illiteracy. Okay, I would like to add one point here, that if we have limited number of schools and colleges, then we have to face the illiteracy. Why? Because without schools and colleges we cannot learn. Clear? So this is the very important point. Next, we have illiteracy. How we have to face the illiteracy problem? So the first reason is, just now we have seen that shortage of schools and colleges. Without education we cannot be called literate people. Okay, if we have fulfilled the basic education, that is up to 10th standard, then only we can be called as a literate people. Okay, educated one. But if many number of children are there, then they have to face illiteracy. This problem is arising due to the shortage of schools and colleges also. And one another reason is if many children or many members are there in a family, in a poor family, then they cannot afford every children to go to the school. They cannot afford the fees of the schools. So what they will do, they will engage their children into some or other activities so that they can generate money to fulfill their family requirements. That's why this illiteracy is also very much biggest problem for we are facing nowadays. Next, we have increasing unemployment. If we do not have literate, if we do not have education degrees, then no one is ready to give us job. So unemployment ratio is increasing. Unemployment means people, those who do not get the job, they are known as unemployed. Okay, unemployed means they do not have any kind of job to do for earning money. See, this man is searching for the job. Yes, he is educated. Just look at him. He is educated. His clothing is also very good. He is going for the interview, but he didn't have the job. So he is required job. So just because of the population, we have number of seats in schools and colleges, same way we have number of vacant seats in the offices and other employment opportunities also. So it is not possible that each and every candidate will get the job. Clear? Next, just to look at this picture. See, many people in this picture, you can find out that they are searching job. They are just want any kind of job. So they are going some or the other way to find the job. They are the uneducated people. Okay. Next, we have increasing poverty. Dear students, this all points are interconnected. Please keep in mind very clearly. Increase in poverty. See, first point we have discussed is shortage of food and water. Second, we have illiteracy. Shortage of schools and colleges. If we do not have study in school or colleges, then we will call illiterate. So third problem is illiteracy. Then if we are illiterate, then what is the next cause or the next result is we do not get the job. And if we do not get the job, then what will happen? Poverty will increase. We will become poor without money. If we have the job, then and then only we will get the salary, we will have the money. But if we do not have job, we do not have business, anything, then how we will get the money? No, though we cannot get money, and without money we will become poor. So the next problem is increase in poverty. Just look at the picture. See the family here. The members are members of the family, and they are so poor that they do not have the shelter, they do not have the home, food, water. For each and every small things, they have to work so hard to get one time of food for their family. See, so many children are, just look at their clothing style. Okay, they do not have enough clothes to wear. Okay, and they do not have enough food. Just look at here. Many people are sharing from some handful amount of rice. So this is the poverty. If we will not learn, if we will not educated, if we will not study, then the end result is poverty. Clear? Next, we have our government has also taken some of the steps to reduce this kind of problem. Which are the steps taken by the government? So first one is different programs introduced to generate employment opportunities in villages. Okay, वी ऑल नो दैट एज कम्पेयर टू द सिटी एरियाज विलेजेस आर लाइक लेस डेवलप्ड. ओके नो लाइक नो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चरल फैसिलिटीज नो अदर एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज कैन बी अवेलेबल फॉर द पीपल ऑफ विलेजेस. ओके सो गवर्नमेंट इज ऑफरिंग दैम अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू जनरेट द एम्प्लॉयमेंट इन द विलेजेस ओनली. So first one is, see which kind of programs government has introduced for the villagers. Nowadays you can also see in the TV advertisement and everywhere there that government is taking care of the villagers or village people to educate the women in the living in the villages. Government has started free of cost computer education for the women. Okay, free of cost education system for the old age people, for the illiterate people. Next, government is also helping the villagers to generate their employment opportunity, like how to generate the money. They have the skills, they can easily make this kind of baskets from the grass or bamboos. They have the skills, but they do not have the market, they do not have the customers. Then whom to sell this particular product? So government will buy this products, craft products from this type of villagers, and then government will sell them in the open market. Like this way government is also helping the villagers nowadays. Next, we have availability of better medical facilities. Okay, previously when government was not taken initiation, at that time in villages, if someone is sick or if they need a hospital facility, then they have to go to the city area and they have to hospitalize that particular patient in the city hospital only, because in the villages we do not have enough medical facilities. Developed one clinics are not available in the villages, but nowadays the all the facilities can be available in the villages only. See, doctors, educated doctors, skillful doctors are there for the villagers in the, and see, the hospitals are also being developed by the government for the villagers. Next, schools and colleges, it is also been opened up in the villages. It is the initiation of the government. See, now many children can go to the schools and colleges. Previously what happened, due to the insufficiency of the schools and the colleges, many people, many like parents, they are not agreed to send their children to go out of the villages and they can study over there. So what they will do, they will just stop their study. Okay, they do not send their children to the school due to the schools are not available in the villages. But nowadays schools, many schools have been available in the villages, so each and every child can go to the schools and can be literate, can be can get the education. And in colleges have been opened up in the villages. So due to this, they suppose the in a school child will get 12th standard education till 12th standard, but what afterwards? So because there were no colleges, so they have to stop their study from the middle only. But now after the colleges have been opened up, every child can go to the college in their village only, so they can complete their education. Next, we have spreading awareness about birth control methods. Okay, birth control methods means how to control the population. Okay, so government is now giving the advertisements, organize seminars in the villages and aware them how, what are the benefits of a small family, how can they control their family members. ओके सो फैमिली प्लानिंग एडवाइज एंड फैमिली प्लानिंग इम्पोर्टेंस हैज बीन टॉट बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू द विलेजर्स क्लियर नेक्स्ट स्प्रेडिंग अवेयरनेस अबाउट एजुकेशन ओके गवर्नमेंट इज ऑल्सो स्प्रेडिंग अवेयरनेस सी लाइक सर्व शिक्षा अभियान प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामीण डिजिटल साक्षरता अभियान बेटी पढ़ाओ बेटी बढ़ाओ अभियान ठीक है सो लाइक दिस वे गवर्नमेंट इज स्प्रेडिंग अवेयरनेस इन द विलेजर्स दैट दे हैव टू सेंड देयर चिल्ड्रन वॉट एवर इट इज बॉय और गर्ल दे हैव टू सेंड देयर चिल्ड्रन टू द स्कूल्स फॉर द बेसिक स्टडी सो दैट दे कैन अर्न मोर एंड दे कैन चेंज देयर लाइफ So this all are the steps taken by the government to stop this particular problem of population. Okay, and how the people can improve their life, the quality of life in the villages also. So this is all done. Thank you so much. Here we are ending with this chapter human resources I hope it is clear to you if you have any doubt you can ask to me but before that please review the lecture and revise very good in a very good way at your home thank you so much